to John P. Severing from Dennis McCleary, dated 12 June 1936.
Dear John, yes, I'm writing. After all this time, how's the publishing game these days? I know you probably don't want to hear from an old has-been like me, but there's some news to share about Rosamund's, how should I say, hard-to-treat conditions. She's been under the care of Highland Psychiatric. It's the third time she's there, a psychiatric hat-trick.
A mental hospital?
Nevertheless, the doctors have been encouraged by her progress and think a few days spent back home in what they call a family atmosphere might hasten her recovery even more.
Oh, you're writing.
Just a letter.
Want a brandy?
I've already had four, and it's going all right. We are speaking softly.
I'll pour one for me.
But she's grown so thin, her eyes look within, and they don't always recognize me. I'll say one wrong word, and the horse is spurred, and well, stitches have been sown. This business of my being on the wagon doesn't help much either. I've strictly limited my intake to white wine with lunch, red wine with dinner, and cognac before bed. But it's not helping me hack out any stories because all I seem to be able to do is remember. Do you know what I keep thinking of, John? First day of April 19.
The first day of April 1919.
You've probably forgotten all about it.
Huh.
You had just moved in to that office suite where the manuscripts filled up the floor. You had worlds to win, there'd be no retreat. And that's when I burst through your door. You could change men's lives, and mine needed change. And I begged you to give me the nod. A man's fate arrives if it's at close range, and he reaches out for it from God. And at first you said no, but then you said yes. I got married and moneyed, the book went to press. That novel made both our careers. After all these years, the violet hour, the violet hour. Rose?
Editor's note, here there's a gap in the page, and when the letter resumes, the handwriting becomes jagged and indecipherable in places.
Hours later, I am back to say that Rosamund's returned to Highland. There were screams and a knife. She had tried to, it was bloody. Thank God in this house, the kitchen's near the study.
No, I can't keep reading this.
John, please, this is what I need to ask you. As I'm writing the new novel, we need money. We lost it all in the crash. And I'm wondering if you might consider a modest loan. No, a better thing, a republishing in some kind of new edition of the early stuff. It would be enough to keep her in good care. The The Violet Hour might be able to draw attention as a period piece, you know? And I really believe that if people were reminded of how good I used to be, they'd receive me better now.
Denny.
Denny.
No wonder how she's doing over there. In the old days, when she felt this madness coming on, she'd secretly rent a room at the plaza and hide away until she was fit to return to people. Maybe if everything had happened differently back then, it would be all right today. Maybe the only thing separating us from contentment is the price of a hotel room. But then her laugh, I can't decipher it. I gave my whole goddamn life for it. I guess it's a code. What she's lost, what she's owed. How she hates me. That laugh runs me through. And there's nothing to do. It denigrates me. It devastates me.
Stop!
But on April 1st, 1919, the world was as new as the dawn. Now it's all reversed. We can't wipe it clean. I've gone too far and she's too far gone. And though you told us yes, at first you said no. And I wish I could go back to ages ago.